Hey Thrive Kids, happy Sunday morning. I hope you're ready to have service with us today. So let's go ahead, let's get on our feet. Get brother, get sister, make sure you are ready, you have enough space to move, because what comes up first? Worship. So if you're ready, maybe you're ready for a VBS song, maybe you're ready for a worship song, get ready for that. Hey, also, some of us might be sitting, and that's okay. But if you can stand, awesome. Make sure you're doing as many movements as you can. But if you're sitting at home with your family, also do the movements while you're sitting. We are so great multitaskers, right? We can do so many things. So if you're standing, get all those wiggles and energy out. But if you're sitting too, because maybe you're not too comfortable, that's okay. Make sure you're still doing the movements while you're sitting. I know sometimes when I'm watching service, I'll be sitting during worship and I'm still like, yes, it's so good. Worship's so good. So make sure you're doing the same. Also, find that person that's going to pray at the end, all right? We have some awesome things going on today, so let's get into it. Worship time.
There's a spirit I cannot contain. There's a spirit I cannot contain. The same power that raised Jesus up from the grave. The same spirit I cannot contain.
your presence.
I just want you, oh, and nothing else.
person. Hopefully you're ready. So Jesus, we thank you, God, for all that you've done for us this week and through this worship time. We ask you that you would open our hearts, you would open our minds to be ready to receive what you have for us today. God, I pray that you bless our families, you bless our friends, you bless those around us, God, in this season, and even through our worship time, even through our Bible stories and all the stuff that we're gonna do today. I pray that you would help us be connected to you somehow, some way, to glorify you on this beautiful Sunday. We love you, and your turn. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Awesome job, guys. If you are practicing praying at home, this is the perfect time. Maybe there's someone in your house that you need to pray for. Maybe there's someone in your family that you need to pray for. These are the times that are so, so important to practice praying in your own home, because that's where we're supposed to pray, in our houses. And then when we all come together again, we'll be able to pray even more freely when we're all together. So friends, I encourage you, please practice praying. When I say it's your turn, take it. Say, okay, if no one chose, I'm still gonna do it, okay? So let's see, we did worship, and so now it's, do you know? Announcement time, let's go. Okay guys, here are the announcements for today. So every Sunday around 9, 10 o'clock, our kids' service is online. So you can find it on our YouTube channel. It'll also have our links on our Facebook, Dive Kids Lathrop, and then you'll also see the link in our Instagram bio, Thrive Kids Lathrop, as well. So go ahead and check out our Facebook, our Instagram, and our YouTube channels. We have so many different things going on, and as we start stepping into the summer, you're gonna see a lot more stuff. So please, if you have a Facebook, join us on our Facebook account. If you have Instagram, join us on our Instagram. Maybe you know someone that should know what we're doing. Maybe they're kind of connected, or maybe trying to be connected, but you know that they want to be involved or should be involved. Or maybe they just want to give them more resources. Please go ahead and let them know that they can connect through those avenues, Facebook and Instagram. Our YouTube channel, it's for all those things too, but sometimes it's just like videos. So if you want more relational stuff during the week, you go ahead and stick to our Facebook and Instagram, and that's kind of our best bet there. We do have lives on Wednesdays at 5 o'clock, and we have our fun Fridays at 4. We try to do some stuff for our kiddos so they have something to do over the weekend. Also, we have our last Zoom meetings this week. So Tuesday and Wednesday Zoom times for our kids with Teacher Dylan and with myself, this is our last Zoom meeting. And we wanna make sure that you guys get a chance to join and participate, do something fun. We also have a fun announcement for the heat wave that's about to come in. So please go ahead, and if you wanna get engaged with those Zoom times, our last Zoom time this week, go ahead and email us at kids@thrivelathrop.com. It should be right below me. And if maybe you don't want to do it through email, you can also message us on Facebook and on Instagram to go ahead and get the Zoom link for our Tuesday night and our Wednesday afternoon Zoom times. We have some fun stuff. I know for my Wednesday class, we are doing a talent show. So if you have a talent that you want to show us, maybe you know how to do a cool skateboard trick, maybe you know how to do something fun, maybe you know how to do a dance, or maybe, I don't know, you sing a song, whatever your talent is, maybe it's just doing art, you guys know. Maybe you like to tell jokes. I know Some kids like to tell jokes. So maybe that's something that you want to be a part of. On Wednesday at 3:30, or that's what we're doing at on our Zoom time for everyone gets, I think it's 10, I think we said 10 to 20 seconds of talent show time. So, and then Teacher Dylan always has something fun for the kiddos. But yes, go ahead, get engaged, message us so you can get that Zoom link. And our Zoom links are different. So Tuesday night and Wednesday afternoon, try to get into one of those if you can. Also, we have our drive-in worship night coming this coming Saturday, May 30th. Yes. So go ahead. And if you want to come and be a part of that, or if you want more info, please let us know. You are going to do something a little bit different, something that we're not typically a part of or had to think of, but it's going to be amazing worship in your car. We're not going to get out of the car, but you are going to be able to see people and be a part of something that is about Thrive, like we all love Thrive, right? That's why we're here. So if you want to come out and be a part of that, that's going to be this coming Saturday, which is going to be so fun. Well, kiddos, that's all I have for you for announcements anyways. So go ahead, get ready, because you know what's next. This is the last Sunday that we are going to use our emoji game. So enjoy it, because next week we're going to have something new and I hope you like it. So get close to the TV, run up to the front, get ready to see how it changes and what's going on, because it's our last time to do emoji search. So get ready, set, and go! Did you find all of them? I hope you did. They can get so tricky sometimes, but I really like the emojis this week. Let me know in the comments which was your favorite emoji to find. So, unfortunately, that's the last time we're gonna do our emoji game. I have something special for you next week. Let us know in the comments too if you guys know any cool games to do, because we are always looking to add new things. But of course, we're gonna have something fun next week like usual. Our theme this week, we're gonna dive into and get right into the lesson. You ready? So, you guys know that our theme is unstuck, don't give up. I love this theme. I think it's perfect timing for the season we're in. How many of you have made slime so far? Let us know if you've made slime, because obviously this is pretty slimy. Don't you like how it moves? It's pretty cool, huh? So, I know you guys know that we are not gonna give up, we are not stuck, and that we are always growing and moving forward all the time. So, Are you ready for what you know? You know. You know what's coming next. So if you know what's next, shout it out wherever you're at. So we did worship, we did our game, and now it is our memory verse. So get to your feet, stand up, get in front of your screen, get ready, kind of do a little squat, put your hands on your side, or maybe you just want to focus and just go like this, whatever the case may be. Your memory verse is coming, and you have 30 seconds to say it as many times as you can. We have so many kids that are learning it and memorizing it so, so well. It's so good. So if maybe this is just your practice time, you have practice time every Sunday to practice this memory verse. Are you ready? It's coming. Ready, set, go. Okay, guys, how many times did you say the memory verse? I know it's pretty long. I know last time I think Valentino was able to say it 5 times, or maybe it was 3. I can't remember. It was around there. But this verse is so good, so I hope you said it as many times. If you are able to say it 10 times within the 30 seconds, let me know in the comments. Say, I did 10 times, or maybe put your name and then say, I did it 10 times. Let me know. Make sure you're telling the truth, because that is so awesome. You must be very fast talkers. So anyways, memorize this verse, write it down, practice it at home. The last couple of weeks, we've had Fun Friday games that involve knowing the verse. So if you want to practice, maybe not just writing in paper, maybe you want to actually do something to practice it, go to our Facebook or our Instagram pages, and we have games that go along with our memory verse for you to be able to practice. So learning your memory verse is so important, so you can write it on your heart, because when you write it on your heart, it does not go away, let me tell you. So let me think, what's next? Help me, guys. What do I do next? Oh, yes, you're right. If you were able to say it out loud, I hope that was you speaking to my brain. So we did worship. We did our game. We did our memory verse. So now let's jump into, what do you think? Say it out loud. Tell me. Help me. I can't hear you. It's the so-and-so show. So when I say so-and-so, you say show. So-and-so, so-and-so. Let's go watch the so-and-so show.
Ah. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Bucket. You got this. You got this. Use the force. Ah.
Hey.
Hey.
You mind if I,
What?
Take a try?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right. Huh.
Ha! You got one in.
Ha! No, you got one in.
Ha! airplane, though.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for tuning in today. I'm Brandon.
And I'm Jeff.
And this is the So-and-So Show. Today, we have a great show in store for you. Hang on to your seats, pews, pillows, whatever you sit on while watching this show, because it's going to be a good one. First up, a competition game. Who can flip their water bottle and land it the most times in a row? Go. Go. Oh, hey, I will. It looks like I won. Next thing, random Christmas carols in the summer. Hey, deck the halls with ice cream sundaes. Fa la 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 la. Tis the season
Brandon.
To go swimming. Fa la 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 la. You what? Yes.
What are you doing?
I was doing the show.
The show on 17 cups of Fred's Fast Fraps?
What? No.
Well, what's with the racehorse pace?
Well, I was just trying to help you out. You know, I saw on your calendar that you have a haircut appointment in 30 minutes, and I didn't want you to be late, so.
What?
Oh, come on, John. Don't tell me you forgot.
No. Of course not. I don't need to go. That was an optional suggestive appointment, not a real one.
Oh, really? Because it says here, a mandatory haircut. You've got this, John. No excuses. I believe in you.
What?
This is your handwriting.
Oh, who would write notes like that to themselves in their own calendar?
Guess you.
Oh. Where were we? Oh, yes, yes.
Don we now our swimming goggles.
John.
John,
you clearly need a haircut. You can't just do the show slowly in hopes of getting out of it.
I'm not doing the show slowly.
Are you afraid of haircuts?
What?
Stop doing that.
Okay. Okay, fine. Yes.
Brandon! Help me!
What?
Fine. Yes, I'm scared of haircuts, okay? Are you happy now?
No, I'm not. I mean, look, John, there's nothing to be scared of. I mean, the people cutting your hair know what they're doing, and they went to hair college and everything. Well, yeah, they did. And even if they cut your hair shorter than you want, it'll grow back. You shouldn't let fear ruin your beautiful hair.
You think my hair is beautiful?
Whoa. How long has that been up there?
Only a year or two.
Okay, you definitely should go to that appointment.
Can we just get back to the show, please?
Fears are natural, but that doesn't mean you have to live by them. And think of all the times that you've been able to overcome your fears. You remember that time with the ice? Hey, I got us some water.
Oh, thank you.
There you go. What is wrong with you?
Ice!
No, it's good. It's good. Here, try. Here, try it.
Wow. That is refreshing.
See?
Yeah, but that was ice.
Oh. What about the calculators?
$46,723 divided by 17, then distributed to 23 different departments. Let's see.
That's 2,748.7647.
What is
that? It's a calculator. It's a...
No.
No, I can divide it into 23 too if you want.
No.
No, it's fun. It's fun. Try it. Just push equal. I already divided by 23 there. Here you go. 190.
Wow! That is really fast. It's like mathematical magic.
Come on. It's time to face another fear.
Maybe.
Need I remind you of the teddy bears?
Oh,
bears. You are adorable. You are cuddly. And you are soft. And I will not fear thee.
Oh! Yes! These are great! Oh, I love these! Oh, you're so cuddly, you bear! You bear! Why was I afraid of you?
Yeah, that was pretty brave of me.
See, you can totally get a haircut.
Okay. Yeah. You're right. I can, and I will. It's already 2:52. I'm running out of time. We've got to. It's Bible Story Time with Kellen.
Hey, Kellen.
Hey, Kel Bell.
Let's just stick with Kellen.
Kellen it is. What do you have for us today, Kellen?
Well, today I'm telling you about a very humble and incredibly brave guy named Stephen.
Okay, but make it quick. I've got a haircut to get to.
All right. So, after Jesus came back from the dead, the church started to grow very fast. They needed someone to help take care of all of the new believers. Stephen was the person they chose. Stephen was wise, and he was full of faith and of the Holy Spirit. With God's power, Stephen did amazing things for people to see. But there were some who didn't approve of him. They started telling lies about Stephen. They said he was saying things that were against the law. So Stephen was arrested and taken before the Sanhedrin. The Sanhedrin was the Jewish court system where people were judged by a group of religious leaders. They listened to all the lies spoken about Stephen and asked, "Is what these people are saying true?" I want you to understand what was happening here, because times were different back then. The stuff Stephen was being accused of was punishable by death. But instead of backing down, Stephen took a stand. He started to remind them of how God spoke to Abraham thousands of years ago, telling him to move to a new land that God promised to give him and his family. Stephen reminded them of Joseph and how even though he was sold as a slave to Egypt, God was with him and how Joseph eventually became a ruler of Egypt. He talked about Moses, who God spoke to through a burning bush, telling him to go and rescue his people from slavery, and how through many wonders and miracles, Moses led the Israelites out of slavery through the Red Sea. And Stephen reminded the Sanhedrin of how King David's son, Solomon, worked to build a temple so God would have a permanent place to live. But, Stephen said, the Most High God does not live in any houses made by human hands. Stephen told them their entire history, putting together the pieces, how God had been with his people since the beginning, how he had always kept his promises. Then, I'm thinking Stephen probably took a deep breath. Because he was getting to the most important part. He told the Sanhedrin that Jesus was the promised Messiah sent by God, and that they were responsible for Jesus' death. When the members of the Sanhedrin heard this, they became very angry. But Stephen looked up, and he saw what can only be described as the glory of God. And he saw Jesus standing there. "Look," he said, "I see heaven open. The Son of Man is standing at God's right hand." The members of the Sanhedrin didn't want to hear that. They covered their ears. They yelled at the top of their voices. They couldn't see what Stephen was seeing. They didn't know all the pieces of the puzzle. So in their anger and confusion, they ordered that Stephen be put to death. As he died, Stephen prayed, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. And don't hold this sin against them." Stephen had every reason to be afraid, but he was determined to bring honor to God in even the scariest situations. Back to you guys.
Whoa. Yeah. Stephen's definitely braver than me. I'm scared of a haircut.
And teddy bears.
Not anymore.
Well, remember, Stephen wasn't brave all on his own. He was full of the Holy Spirit. God was with him the whole time.
You know something? Whenever I remember that God is with me, it does make me feel more brave.
It should, because God can do anything and because God knows everything. We only see a part of the puzzle, but God sees the whole thing.
Wow. Yeah. Hey, thanks, Kellen. I'm more determined than ever to get my hair cut. You want to come with me?
No way.
Yeah.
We'll see you next time, Kellen.
Yeah, thanks for the story. Bye.
Bye.
All right, John, to the barber with you.
You bet.
But first...
Don't start procrastinating
again. No, it's not that. It's time for Reveal the Question. Boom. When were you scared but kept going? My answer is right now and... Whoa, right now? I gotta run. See ya.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
What about you? When were you scared but kept going? Talk it over and be inspired by each other's bravery. Until next time, I'm Brandon.
Whoa. And I'm John.
Go, what are you doing?
I gotta go. Go.
And this was the So-and-So Show. Bye.
Ah. Bears, you guys are so cool. You're so soft and you're so cuddly and you never gave up on me after all those years. You know what? Thank you so much for always sticking with me even after I was afraid for so long.
Oh! No, get away! Get away! No! No, bears! Attack the bear with the bear!
Man, wasn't that So-and-So Show so funny? They always have something good or something to make us laugh, right? I love the beginning. He was throwing paper airplanes, trying to get into that bucket. How many of you have tried to make a paper airplane and it just falls down just like that? Let me know. Tell me. Or, you know what? Better yet, make a paper airplane and write your memory verse on it. Okay? And then see how many times you can write it and how many times, how far it gets. Anyways, so that story was all about who? You know? It was all about Stephen. So, Stephen was such an amazing man. He did so much, right? And who kind of led Stephen, guided him when he was going through all those things? Tell me. I know there's probably two people that you might name, so go ahead. One of them is most likely who, and then the other, come on, you know it. Let me know in the comments what your answers were, okay? So, the Holy Spirit was really guiding Stephen. Of course, Jesus was able to pour into his life, and the story of Jesus is what really empowered him. But the Holy Spirit is the one who kind of led him and guided him through all those things. So, friends, our question today is, when were you scared but kept going? Stephen, man, imagine being Stephen in that time. You know, there had to have been a little bit of fear, right? Maybe a lot of fear. We don't really know. How many of you have ever been scared or maybe fearful or maybe just worried? All those emotions and those feelings are real. They're real things. So, just like Stephen put all of his trust, put all of his hope in Jesus and who he was, Stephen's life was just to honor God. He was so selfless. Do you think he just thought about himself? To do all those things, he had to not just be thinking about himself. He had to really just be focused on Jesus throughout the whole thing. Because, man, I can't imagine doing all those things. And the consequence, the things that could have happened to him, he had to still go through. And the Holy Spirit is what led him. So, just like in our so-and-so story, our friend, I think it's John, correct me if I'm wrong, told us that he was scared of just getting a haircut. And Stephen was willing to lay down his life, just like Jesus laid down his life, for the sake of Jesus and who he is. So isn't that amazing? Like, he's just so selfless, just ready to live his life, totally honoring the Lord. And that's how we need to live ours. So let's really dive in. Let's ask ourselves, When were you scared but kept going? I know even this season, this time, some of us might be worried, might be scared, might be a little fearful, might even be a little angry. There's all kinds of different feelings and emotions, but we have to keep going. We have to persevere. We have to endure. We have to trust and know that Jesus is with us, that He is our hope. And honestly, nothing is really better than that. Really, I mean, you could probably have a good piece of cake, but good piece of cake ain't gonna get you through. But Jesus does. So, anyways, friends, I want you to answer that question. When were you scared but kept going? Sometimes I'm scared of the dark, but you know what? I know Jesus is with me and I'm able to run across the hallway and make it over to my bedroom where I know it's safe. So, anyways, friends, answer that question. Let us know what your answer is. Let us send us a video, send us maybe put something in the comments to let us know that you are answering, you are participating, and you are engaged. Because that's so important. We have to constantly feed our soul and really challenge our mind to focus on what Jesus has for us. So answer that question. And that's all I have for you guys today. I also have a little slide from what the kids shared in our Zoom time for our scriptures. So go ahead and check out those scriptures and maybe you can read them this week too. So I love you guys, miss you guys so much. Let's pray. And we'll see you guys next Sunday. So Jesus, we thank you for all of our Thrive kids. We ask that you cover them, that you bless them, that they would be empowered, that Holy Spirit, you would lead and you would guide them, that you would push and challenge them to keep going, that you would stir hope, that you would stir courage, that you would stir just peace to know that you are with them. We love you, Jesus, and we put all of our hope and trust in you. In Jesus' name, amen. Love you, Thrive Kids. See you next Sunday. Bye.
Who believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
Yeah. Matthew 1, the book of...
Okay. The book of the generations of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. This is the account of Noah and his family. Noah was a righteous man, blameless among people of his time, and he walked faithfully with God. Noah had these sons, Shem, Ham, and Jeph.
Okay, it says, John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life.
Ben.
Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everybody who loves is born of God and always and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love.
Okay.
I'm tired of doing good. At the right time, you will gather probably don't get
love. Yeah. Good job. Why did you choose that one?
Because it encourages me to not give up.
Yeah.
When Jesus spoke again to people, he said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
Eternal life.
But have the light of life.
I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Philippians chapter 4, verse 13.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of my rightness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me, your rod and your staff, and they comfort me.
Awesome.
God continued, my covenant is between me and you and every living creature with you. It is a covenant for all time to come. Here is the sign of the covenant I am making. I have put my rainbow in the cloud. It will be the sign of the covenant between me and the earth.
But at the right time, we will gather crop if we don't give up. Is it Galatians? How do you say that?
Yeah, Galatians, you got it.
Galatians.
Good job. Awesome. Thank you so much, Michaela.